Hi friends, you're watching Movie Reviews with Raghuram. I just saw the trailer of 83. Stupendous, marvelous, brilliant, awesome. What editing of the trailer. I should really appreciate the trailer. The trailer was mind-blowing and it gives you goosebumps. It gives you an impression of seeing the 1983 entire World Cup live. The match between India and Zimbabwe, the match between India and West Indies. I think they were mainly occupying the frames of the trailer. We will get to see quite a lot of or almost all the matches that India has played in the 1983 World Cup when the movie releases on the big screen. It will be a fantastic and marvelous cinematic experience to see 1983 World Cup being recreated. Every frame of the World Cup, every glory, every moment of glory, every moment of emotion, every moment of loss and win being recreated by Kabir Khan and his team and being presented to us in a marvelous cinematic experience on the big screen. It will be worth waiting for the movie 83. Really heart-touching and goosebump-giving trailer this was of 83. Now going to the end of the trailer, we are shown with every character, every player, every key component of the playing 11 of 1983 World Cup. We can see the Kapil Dev, we can see Gavaskar, Srikanth, Kirmani, Madanlal, Kirti Azad, Sandhu, everybody who scripted that famous win for India. That particular World Cup which changed the fate of Indian cricket, which also got glory to India and also paved the way and pathway for many glories to come in the upcoming days and upcoming years. Fantastic, fantastic recreation of every frame of the World Cup. Every actor playing the role of cricket players on the screen are looking almost exact replica of the real players. I should tell, intense research has been put into this particular movie in terms of the actors becoming the players themselves, going into the skin of the character, the body language, the language they speak, the way they bowl, the way they bat, the way they speak, the way they present themselves. Everything has been researched thoroughly and it has been presented on the big screen for us. Just for example, we get to see the accent of Krishnamachari Srikanth and also the Kapil Dev. They're almost the same while speaking, including the facial expressions, the body language and the gimmicks what Srikanth does in his face. Tremendous, awesome. And in one of the press conferences, the way Kapil Dev speaks, the way Ranveer Singh speaks, I just thought I am seeing Kapil Dev speaking. And this time in the trailer, we are shown Kapil Dev hitting that ball out of the park in a style of his own. In the teaser, we were shown Kapil Dev running towards that particular catch to complete the catch of Vivian Richards to win the World Cup glory for us. And in this trailer, we can see Kapil Dev smashing that ball out of the park. Apart from that, the initial scene while Kapil Dev is taking the bath and he comes and screams outside, "Are you people really joking?" And then he changes his expression and asks. Ranveer Singh in that particular scene exactly looks like Kapil Dev, and his funny moments are fantastic. So we know that Indians were underdogs and they were written off out of the World Cup. In couple of press conferences also, we can see Ranveer Singh in the form of Kapil Dev tell that we are here to win, and the press reporters asking in a sarcasm, "Is it the World Cup you have come to win?" And then Kapil Dev telling, "What else we have come for?" Fantastic. We can see Indian team put to humiliation at many points. One example is shown in the trailer where the team manager is asking for the team bus while West Indies team are majestically walking towards their bus. I should tell, Pankaj Tripathi in the role of team manager is also fantastic. And that scene where Srikanth behaves in his typical pattern while getting introduced to the Queen. So there are some fun moments also, moments of glory, moments of loss, as I already said, lot of emotions involved in the movie. And you can see the crowd cheering, crowd celebrating, and back in India, how the Indian fans were celebrating and how some Indian fans who are keen followers of Indian fans are celebrating every moment and waiting for India to lift that World Cup, and some Indians writing India off and Indian captain also off. So Kapil Dev and his team had to write off those critics and prove themselves on the cricketing scenario in the international front. And they had a big task and big uphill task to beat two times world champions West Indies in the final. And wow, what a match it would be when you see on the big screen. It will definitely create goosebumps. That match and that match in which Kapil Dev happened to smash that 175 runs against Zimbabwe to take India ahead. We can also see Deepika Padukone in a couple of frames. She also looks really awesome. And every frame, I think, in the movie belongs to Kapil Dev. And none other than Ranveer Singh has played the role of Kapil Dev. The iconic character of Kapil Dev. I think for Ranveer Singh, it is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. And just by seeing the teaser and trailer, I feel that he has done immense justice to the role by fitting himself into the shoes of Kapil Dev. Again, awesome, wonderful, beautifully edited trailer, I should tell. I just loved the trailer to peaks. If the teaser of 83 was an appetizer, this trailer is a tempter, man. The movie 83 will be a pre-Christmas release and it will be releasing in theaters on 24th December 2021 and I'll be keenly waiting to watch this magnum opus and all the matches of 1983 World Cup being recreated and I would definitely be waiting to see India lift that 1983 World Cup once again by not Kapil Dev but by Ranveer Singh and his team at Lord's. This will be a terrific big screen experience and I am in keen wait for 83. Thanks for watching my video. If you loved my video, kindly like, share and subscribe to my channel. I'll catch up with you all in my next video with yet another movie review. Until then, do take care. Goodbye. Namaste.